Hello my friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Victor, I'm a flight attendant, and every week with you I share some tips on how to travel in better conditions. This week we're going to talk about something quite explosive. We're going to talk about lithium battery. Welcome aboard. Lithium batteries are everywhere. I myself carry at least 10 of them pretty much at all time when I'm traveling. So here are some examples. The first one that you probably have one is just a phone. And then another one, which I always carry with me, is my laptop. There's a big lithium battery in it to make it work for hours. There will be my watch. Actually, I'm an Apple fan, so I've got my Apple Watch, but guess how it works? It's a battery in it. It's a lithium battery. Another one that I take with me, not Apple, but my toothbrush, electric toothbrush. I recharge it, so the battery to hold the power in it. So there we go. Oh, I get sprayed. I also carry an iPad with me for work, and also the keyboard for the iPad. So that's one too. And then because I'm a big Apple fan, I also bought recently those beautiful, I love them, those earpods, as they call them, I think. So there's 1, 2, and 3 batteries. So in total, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 batteries. Doesn't count the one in the camera and the spare batteries I've got with me. That's 12. 12 when I'm traveling. Imagine you've got, let's say, an average of 10 batteries per person, and then you've got a plane with 300 passengers. That's 3,000 lithium batteries just in the cabin that I used. On the top of that, you're allowed to have some spare ones. So many airlines will let you travel with 15 batteries on yourself, and then an extra up to 20 extra batteries that you can take with you. 20 is quite a lot. So how does it work? So the batteries need to travel with you in the cabin. They cannot be in a hold. It's completely forbidden, just because, as you may have heard, those batteries explode. Here's a video of a computer that's exploding. And of course, it happened like suddenly. You don't see it coming. You've seen many videos of people who have e-cigarettes and they have them in their pocket. They get crushed a little bit, or they might not be a very good quality. And then suddenly the battery just explodes, ignite, and then you start to have a fire on you. Lithium battery can condense a pile of energy, and if it explodes, it will start a fire. The way is also to prevent this kind of explosion. If you have any spare battery, like I know the one with my camera, I'll always put some tape on the connectors to make sure it doesn't get in contact with anything. Don't let them be in contact with keys or coins, because that might create a short circuit. That's like any electronic thing. Make sure they are actually in the temperatures at control, so they don't like when it's become too hot, and also sudden change of temperature are not always very good for them. Don't put them in a loose bag. They should be protected, but also never squash. If you squash a lithium battery, the explosion will start again. So again, there's a lot of factors to protect them. There's many ways you can make them completely safe, but always keep in mind those things can explode. And I'm always a little bit worried, to be honest, with the one in my ears. I don't want to start to have an explosion in my ear. So I've seen some fake Apple ones. I don't know how good they are, but I wouldn't risk to lose my earring for the rest of my life just because I wanted to save $100. So what's happening if you leave a battery inside your check-in bag? Well, in many airports now, after you say goodbye to your bag on the belt and it goes away, it will be x-rayed. And if they find a lithium battery, two options. First one, the best one, they will just call you back, and then you'll have to come and pick it up, and that's fine. And you can take it with your carry-on bag. If they can't find you, or it's too late because I might delay the flight, they will just open your bag, take it away from your bag, leave a note that they picked it up, and with their phone number or an email address, and then put your bag back in the plane. But you don't know until you arrive that your extra spare battery is not there anymore. So the airport authority will store it. It's not given back to the airline. It's usually kept by the airport authority. They'll store it in their warehouse, usually for a very, very short amount of time, just because otherwise they will need a huge warehouse for all the one that never be claimed. And then you contact them, and they'll tell you the hefty price to have it shipped. First, you will need to pay for the labor, for the person to go and do the packaging and ship it to you safely. Second, with the biggest part, will be the transport with the insurance. Because yes, it will be sent by plane, but in that case, it will be sent as cargo. So the cargo companies will know how to carry commercial items with dangerous goods, which lithium battery are part of it. They will know exactly where they are in the load of the plane, and then they will be put in an area that is actually more monitored for temperature, for smoke, for fire and everything, and with close enough to any fire extinguisher or sprinklers or any device that they have to stop any fire risk. Of course, there's a risk, it stays here. It's more a little bit more limited because there's better control that's made. And of course, the cost is much more expensive because you'll have to pay a high insurance to send this kind of product over an aircraft. With that saying, you can't reduce the risks to zero, but at least now you're aware why we can't carry lithium batteries. Remember not to put them in your check-in bag. That includes also those battery packs, you know, those extra battery that you carry to recharge your phone on the go, to play Pokemon or anything. They should always be in your carry-on bag, never on a hold. Or if you have those great mini scooters or electric skateboards and everything, usually you cannot take them. And some airline, you're allowed to take the battery out and take it with you in the cabin, but most airline won't let you do it. So always refer to the website of the airline that you're going to be flying with and just search lithium battery on their website and you'll find all the answers. Thanks for following me. Next week we'll talk about silly and sometimes stupid comments that passengers have made on board, or questions, mostly questions, and how we try to answer that and try to be quite polite when we answer them. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, feel free to do so. Just click on the button that's actually on this side, or you can click on my big face at the end of the video, and then you can also share this video with anyone you know that's been traveling soon. You can give a thumb up, and also if you want to know more about airline and how to travel in better conditions, there's like about 200 videos in my library, so it's probably something that you might like to watch. On that note, I'll see you next week. Bye.